The difference between the impossible and the possible lies in a person's determination. And this determination and dedication is what has changed a simple dream into reality. The city with the zero milestone, Nagpur, is often referred to as the heart of India because of its central location. Also known as the Orange City of India, Nagpur bears testimony to a glorious past as the capital city, first of the Gond kings and subsequently of the central provinces and Berar. The city still bears the legacy of the past with its wonderful historic monuments and buildings. The grand Kastur Chand Park, the majestic Vidhan Bhavan, the Reserve Bank of India, the High Court, the Deeksha Bhumi are some of the landmarks of the city. At the top of the city, situated on the Seminary Hills, is the majestic Raj Bhavan, which was first built as a landmark site in central India in 1891 and named as the House of the Chief Commission, Central Province and Berar. After Nagpur was declared the second capital of Maharashtra, it was assigned status of Raj Bhavan. In this land of the zero milestone, from almost nothing, the biodiversity project was started in 2008 and has been completed in record time. The biodiversity park has been created around the Raj Bhavan buildings, covering an area of 30 hectares.
येथील जंगल परिसर असुरक्षित असल्यामुळे वर्षानुवर्ष येथील बरीच अशी वृक्षतोड झालेली होती. सर्व जंगल परिसर बॅरन दिसत होता. या परिसराला निसर्गरम्य करण्याकरता या जागेची सुरक्षा, पैसा व पाण्याची व्यवस्था करणे फार गरजेचे होते. त्याचप्रमाणे या प्रोजेक्टची पैशाची गरज मॉइलने पूर्ण केली.
फंड्स फॉर द प्रोजेक्ट अराउंड 140 लाख were graciously provided by the Manganese Ore India Limited, the largest manganese ore company in the country. The project has not just been to plant trees, but rather a fight to remove unwanted and invading species of plant and reforming a dry and a bland landscape into a beautiful green zone with diverse species of plants from all over the country.
माझे 10 वर्ष जुने स्वप्न मी आज प्रत्यक्षात अनुभवतोय.
The biodiversity park has been divided into several zones in a scientific manner to give beauty to the park all year round.
राजभवनला यायला दोन मुख्य मार्ग आहेत. VIP मार्गाला आणि सदर मार्गाला आपण सुगंध दरवळेल त्या रोडवरती 12 महिने असे आपण प्लांट स्पीसीज लावलेले आहे. म्हणजे 1-2-3 महिने एका श्रबला फ्लावर येतील तर त्यानंतरच्या श्रबला पुढल्या 2-3 महिन्यांकरता फ्लावर्स राहतील. त्याच्या बाजूलाच आपण 10 प्रकारचे लँडस्केप डिझाईन्स केलेले आहे.
The biodiversity park have been planted over 49 hectare area. It comprises of sacred species plantation, medicinal species plantation, plantation of palm species, bamboo species, nakshatravan, dashmul species plantation, bulbaceous species plantation, various types of cacti, and also a butterfly garden with a different cryptic species.
What can be more refreshing than a walk in the woods with the gentle aroma of the flowers surrounding you, intoxicating you to take on the problems of the real world around us? The aromatic zone has species like Raat Ki Rani, Din Ka Raja, Chafa, etc.
Thank you.
beautiful rose garden with over 250 species of roses has been planted. You can almost smell the roses from where you are sitting here in the lawn.
How can one appreciate the beauty of flowers without a few pricks from the thorns? The cactus garden has several varieties of Indian and exotic cacti.
या वेगवेगळ्या थीम्स नुसार केलेल्या रोपणामुळे इथे या क्षेत्रास शैक्षणिक महत्त्व प्राप्त झालेले आहे आणि म्हणूनच आपण शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांना या जैवविविध प्रकल्पामध्ये येण्याची संधी देणार आहे आणि त्यातून निसर्ग शिक्षण साधणार आहे.
The bamboo plays a major role in the livelihood of rural people and rural industry and in the social economic development. Bamboo has various versatile uses as building material, paper pulp resource, food, weaving material, etc. Several species of bamboo have been planted and preserved in the biodiversity park. The palm trees always give a feeling of freedom and abundance, reminding you of the vast oceans and a beach with a gentle breeze. The palmatum has several species of palm trees, like the triangular palm, Kentia palm, the European fan palm, Rapis palm, the fishtail palm, and the red lipstick palm.
या विविधतेत जर आपण बघितलं तर बऱ्याच काही वनस्पती आहेत. ही सर्व वनस्पती वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणी, वेगवेगळ्या राज्यात, वेगवेगळ्या शहरात, वेगवेगळ्या खेड्यांमध्ये पसरलेली आहे. पण याच्यातले बरेचसे वनस्पती नाहीसे होण्याच्या रूपात आहे असं म्हणायला हरकत नाही. आणि त्या वनस्पतीला जगण्याकरता जे आवश्यक न्यूट्रियंट्स पाहिजे, आवश्यक माती पाहिजे, हे सगळं सर्व आम्ही निर्माण करून त्या वनस्पतीचं जतन करण्याचा आम्ही कसोशीने प्रयत्न करत आहे.
The tradition of worshipping trees has been in the Indian culture for ages. This has been one way of preserving the natural beauty of the country. Apart from commonly found trees like the peepal and banyan, many sacred trees like the bihara, mahua, bakul and apta have been planted in the sacred zones of the biodiversity park.
Several varieties of air purifying trees like kadam, kusum, bakul, hirda, sisu and many others have been planted to keep the air fresh and pure around the Raj Bhavan complex.
India has given the world Ayurveda, but many medicinal and herbal species in India are on the verge of extinction. In the herbal and the medicinal zones, several important and rare species of medicinal plants like Adulsa, Rui, Kasturi Bhendi, Kaner, Kunj and herbs like Pattarchur, Kachur, Karanti have been planted and preserved in these zones. Astrologers believe that each constellation is associated with trees, which are of medicinal, social, aesthetic or economic value. The Nakshatravan is centered around a circle, which is a representation of the various nakshatras on the ground. The circles are divided into arcs, precisely according to the angles these zodiacs subtend on Earth.
A beautiful morning cannot be complete without the chirping of birds. With several trees that attract birds planted in the biodiversity park, More than 180 species of local as well as migratory birds have been spotted. Butterflies are not only an important ecological entity, but also lend beauty to the surroundings. Several plants that attract butterflies have been planted in the butterfly park and have attracted some beautiful species of butterflies. The park has been built on a land reclaimed by building an innovative drainage system by digging trenches to channelize water so it does not stagnate.
It has been a rewarding experience for all the team members of the project who have been working relentlessly, not just to create the biodiversity park, but with the passion for preserving the rich natural treasure of India. While creating the biodiversity park, more than 16,000 of several species of plants have been planted, while preserving the naturally occurring plants. Several innovative projects like drip irrigation system and creating bunds to preserve groundwater have been implemented.
To achieve anything requires faith and belief in yourself, vision, hard work, determination and dedication. All things are possible for those who believe.
Rajbhavan is an extremely important area from ecological point of view. We are extremely grateful to His Excellency, the Governor of Maharashtra, for providing the Forest Development Corporation of Maharashtra an opportunity to be the main agency for development of biodiversity park in this area.
This biodiversity park is a shining example of what belief and determination can do. How one can create something from ground zero in this historic orange city, Nagpur.